Majesties above the fruited plains. America, America, God shed his grace on thee. Have crowned thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountains, majesties above the fruited plains. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Amen. Thank you, Reverend Sally, for bringing up that bass for us. I'm going to ask Stuart Garson, our county chair, to come up and speak, and then we're going to have YMZ come up as well. Stuart Garson, chair of the Cuyahoga County Democratic Party.
Thank you, Congresswoman. Okay. Folks, look, this is possibly the last gasp of reactionary forces that think that they can somehow bring some notion of America, or at least their version of America, back. And it's not going to happen. But nothing matters if we don't get ourselves in the game. And nothing happens until first you get registered. If you're not registered, get that done. Because without registration, this is a moot conversation. Okay? So get registered. Congresswoman said 500,000 folks in Ohio not registered. Good number of those got to be our folks, right? So, you know somebody who's not registered, dig them out of their house, get them down here, or get the form or whatever needs to be done. Call the local county Democratic headquarters. We'll help you get that done. But look, we're not going back. But that doesn't mean that these guys aren't trying to reinvent some wheel that is just awful. And we know what it is. I don't care how you dress up this pig. We know what it is, right? Okay. And we're not stupid. And they're never going to get their head around the President of the United States, right? I mean, you know, we know what that's about. So the fact of the matter is, we can win this thing, but as I won't even try to be as eloquent as some of these speakers. I would never want to follow anybody here. So next time, call me first. Just get me out of the way. But notwithstanding, We are going to win this thing because we're not going to let cynical forces keep us from the ballot box. Now, we can go back to a day when voting was only one day, and the only people who could vote by absentee were disabled or elderly. You had to have some unique reason. So we're way beyond that. We just have to get over these next hurdles. But don't, you know, if you don't vote, I'm not putting it on them. I'm putting it on you folks here. Okay? That's it. I don't expect anything from those guys. I expect everything from us. Now, you want, you know, and let me tell you something. Next time somebody tells me, Secretary of State's not important. Oh, really? Really? Now, you start talking about those down ballot office. Oh, what does the Secretary of State do anyway, right? What does the auditor do? You know, if we had held two of those three offices, we draw the lines.
Right.
You know, we're not in this battle. We had just held the House. We had held one chamber. We don't have voter suppression laws. We don't have issue two. We don't have any. And most of us could have enjoyed our summers.
That's
spent the last two summers collecting signatures, and then when we do our job, what do? They pull it off the ballot. Because you did your job too well. So my point is to all of us, I am the grandchild of immigrants on both sides. And I think about my departed grandparents. I have a 95-year-old mother, but everyone's gone. And I think about how they came here on insurmountable odds. A lot of you folks, your ancestors came here involuntarily. But this is your country. This is your country. And we had people who came here voluntarily because they couldn't take it where they were. This was the promise, the hope of a better life. And we owe it to your children, to yourselves, to your neighbors, to your grandchildren, and great-grandchildren yet to come, to give them that better life. If you don't vote, don't blame me. Blame yourselves. Don't blame the people here. This is up to us. We can win it. And let me give one last commercial. This is the absentee ballot. I got a handful of them, but you can go in there and pick them up. You know, my car, what is a stamp these days? I don't know, 45 cents. Tells you how much. I got an office. They mail. They send out the mail. I pay the bills, and I don't even want to look at them anymore. But anyway, this here is early voting, and why this is important. If you do this, if you send this in, and if you're a registered Democrat, and I assume most of you are, we are going. You know, we're not going to let you get off the down ballot. We are going to send you a sample ballot, and you know, after you get done with President Obama and Senator Sherrod Brown and Congresswoman Fudge and our entire congressional delegation, we're going to help you with all those other down ballots. Because let me tell you something, if we don't win those down ballots, we don't change the General Assembly, we don't change nothing. You want to change behavior, you got to do it in the ballot box. That's it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Now, our chairman said something very, very important. You've got to not just vote at the top. You've got to go down that ballot. Remember, he mentioned three. Remember Justice Yvette McGee Brown. We need her on the Supreme Court of the United States.